Tonight on NewsWatch, Al-Qaeda in Iraq. Why some lawmakers say the U.S. needs to be doing more to help stop the terrorists.
Plus, investigating the IRS, the scandal behind the person looking into why the agency targeted Tea Party groups.
And Carolina Panthers star Steve Smith sits down with CBN to talk football and faith. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. Good evening. I'm Mark Martin.
And I'm Wendy Griffith. Iraq is in danger of falling into the hands of Al-Qaeda and its offshoots. And some say the American government isn't doing enough to help. Lori Johnson explains in tonight's top story.
This is video of actual airstrikes perpetrated by the Iraqi military on Al-Qaeda-linked targets in Ramadi this week. It's part of a stepped-up effort by Iraqi troops to get rid of the Al-Qaeda element that's crept into many Iraqi cities since the U.S. pulled out in 2011. But Al-Qaeda is fighting back. Just yesterday, an Al-Qaeda-linked suicide bomber attacked an Iraqi military recruiting center in Baghdad, killing dozens. Fallujah is another city that's seen many clashes between the Iraqi military and Al-Qaeda forces. Many residents there, fearing for their lives, have fled that city, leaving those who remain to fend for themselves. We don't have gas, oil, or benzene, said this Fallujah resident. Meanwhile, in Washington, House Speaker John Boehner accused President Obama of ignoring the recent violence in Iraq.
We must maintain a long-term commitment to a successful outcome there. And it's time that the president recognize this and get engaged.
To which the White House responded,
we are very mindful of the fact that this Al-Qaeda affiliate has created a lot of chaos and carnage in Anbar province, and that's why we are engaged in the effort we are to assist the Iraqi government to help them expel that presence.
The White House says the U.S. will deliver supplies to Iraq, but exactly what the U.S. will send is up for debate in Congress. However, the White House stands firm on its commitment not to send any troops back to Iraq. Lori Johnson, CBN News.
And for more on this, we turn now to our senior international correspondent, George Thomas, who has been to Iraq several times. Welcome, George.
Thank you, sir.
Now, talk a little bit about Al-Qaeda in Iraq. What is behind the recent surge in activity?
Yeah. I mean, you look at these images, it's a bona fide mess. But we were reporting on this back in 2011, when the United States, the Obama administration, clearly telecasted to the entire region that the United States was going to pull out. And this was inevitable. I mean, what Al-Qaeda went after was looking for these areas where the government, the Iraqi government, had no control. I mean, Iraq is now being called a failed state where there is no security apparatus to protect citizens. And so, for example, in the northern part of Iraq, which is Sunni dominated, the Al-Qaeda came in, there was a power vacuum, and in essence started to create all kinds of mess that is potentially, let me tell you, this is potentially, I mean, this could lead to a complete civil war and a breakdown in the country yet again.
Let's talk a little bit more about that. Yeah. Some experts in the region are talking openly about a Shia-Sunni conflict. Yeah. How do you see it?
Look, it's very real, and this division is as old as the faith itself. I look at it as this. Perhaps our viewers can understand it from this perspective. You've got two dominant players in the region, Iran, which is Shia, and you've got Saudi Arabia, which is Sunni. And these two countries are, in essence, fighting for who will dominate and who will be the voice of Islam across the region. And today, this division is clearly, the fault lines are all across the Middle East, from Syria to Iraq to Afghanistan. And in some ways, it reminds me of the Cold War. It's like the Cold War taking place in the heart of the Middle East. Iran and Saudi Arabia are like the America and the Soviet Union fighting for control of this region.
Well, what does this mean for Christians in Iraq?
Look, I mean, I think this, it's been the ongoing challenge and the travesty that we have reported here for many, many years. The exodus, the mass exodus of Christians across the Middle East. We heard reports, 450,000 Christians that have escaped the fighting from Syria, about 1,200 that have lost their lives in Syria. I mean, it's the case all across the region. And unfortunately, it's not going to get any better because of the tension between these two sects within Islam.
Okay. George Thomas, thanks for your time, sir.
You're welcome, sir.
Wendy.
Thanks, Mark. Al-Qaeda-linked groups in Syria may be trying to recruit Americans who travel to the country. The head of the FBI says it's one of his greatest concerns. James Comey told reporters dozens of Americans have traveled to Syria to take part in the civil war there, and that while they're there, Syrian militants have been teaching them terrorism techniques to use once they're back in America. Comey says the FBI is devoting resources to find Americans who may have been recruited.
For nearly 2,700 years, a tribe called B'nai Menasha has kept their Jewish roots, even though they're in India. They believe they're part of the lost tribes of Israel, and now many are returning to their ancient homeland. As Chris Mitchell explains, this return is also seen as biblical prophecy.
Where is my brother? My brother!
Brother found brother, and family members of all ages reunited recently at Tel Aviv's Ben-Gurion Airport. They're part of the lost tribe of Manasseh, called in Hebrew the B'nai Menashe, returning from India back to Israel. The term goes back to ancient times, when 10 of Israel's 12 tribes were banished from the land. Michael Freund of Shavei Israel has worked for years to help bring about these moments. He believes the B'nai Menashe return fulfills biblical prophecy.
We are watching as prophecy comes to life before our eyes. God remembers his promises to his people Israel. God is faithful, and he is gathering his children in from all over the earth.
This is the second part of a long-awaited migration. Nearly 2,000 tribe members live in Israel, but 6 years ago, the government stopped their return. Now the government will permit all the B'nai Menashe, about 7,000, to return.
After 2,700 years of exile, B'nai Menashe is coming back. Out of 10 lost tribes, B'nai Menashe will come back the first. So we did it.
The Assyrian Empire exiled the tribe of Menashe almost 3,000 years ago. Although they settled in northeast India, tribe members kept their Jewish roots for more than 2,000 years. Several Christian organizations helped bring them home.
I'm grateful to God. I'm grateful to our partners out there, Jews and Christians, who stand with us, who pray for us, and who help to facilitate this miracle. I'm grateful to CBN, to Gordon Robertson and Michael Little, and the whole team there.
We support the Aliya, the Jewish people, because we believe it's the hand of God. The Lord said that he scattered the Jewish people, but he would never leave them scattered among the nations. He would always come and find them, even if they were scattered to the ends of the earth. And he said, I'm going to bring your sons from the east in the book of Isaiah. And these are certainly Jewish people, ancient Israelite tribe, that are coming home from the east.
It's something that their ancestors dreamed about for 2,700 years. And despite being cut off from the rest of the people of Israel for so long, the B'nai Menashe never forgot who they are, they never forgot where they came from, and they never forgot where they dreamed of one day returning. And now, thank God, they're back home.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Amen. Well, for more of Chris's exclusive reporting from Israel, make sure you check out his weekly show and blog, Jerusalem Dateline, and you can find them at our website, cbnnews.com.
The leader of the investigation into the IRS targeting of conservative and Tea Party groups is a political supporter of President Obama. That according to a report by the Washington Times. Barbara Bosserman is a trial lawyer in the Justice Department. She donated more than $6,000 to Obama's campaigns in 2008 and 2012. The American Center for Law and Justice represents 41 Tea Party groups in a federal suit against the IRS.
Because of what we know, it raises serious conflict of interest. And as an attorney, she should have known that this would become a scandal within a scandal. So they've got to deal with more partisan politics at play in an issue, an investigation into whether or not conservative groups were illegally targeted by the IRS because of their viewpoint. And the lead investigator from the Department of Justice happens to be someone who strongly disagrees with the viewpoints of these groups.
Congressional Republicans say they haven't been able to get any information from the investigation.
U.S. employers added 74,000 jobs in December, the fewest in 3 years. However, the Labor Department reports the unemployment rate dropped from 7% in November to 6.7%. That's the lowest level since October 2008. That drop happened in part because more Americans stopped looking for work. The government counts people as unemployed only if they are actively searching for jobs. December's hiring is far below the average increase of 214,000 jobs a month in the last 4 months.
Target says at least 70 million customers were affected by their pre-Christmas data breach. That number is substantially more than the chain had previously reported. Last month, Target announced that personal identification numbers were stolen for up to 40 million credit and debit cards. Today, that number went up. Target is now offering free credit monitoring and identity theft protection to all its customers. People will have the chance to enroll over the next 3 months.
The federal government will recognize all the same-sex marriages performed in Utah. Back in December, a judge overturned the state's ban on gay marriage, sending more than 1,000 same-sex couples to get marriage licenses. But on Monday, the Supreme Court ordered a stay on gay weddings while the state appeals the ban being overturned. Today, Attorney General Eric Holder said the federal government will recognize all the weddings that took place, saying the marriage status of gay couples in Utah shouldn't be uncertain during the court battle.
Coming up, the rising cost of last year's historic typhoon in the Philippines.
In 2008, my husband Gary departed for heaven. I was still grieving. And then to find out I had cancer, I began praying, God, how do I do this? Where do I do this? Cancer Treatment Centers of America was the place. Dr. Neelam outlined a plan that would take care of my mind and my body, and she prayed with me.
For Bible-believing Christians, we're able to pray with them in a much deeper way as they begin to really rely upon their faith.
At Cancer Treatment Centers of America, we believe in the power of faith and prayer as indispensable allies in the fight against complex and advanced stage cancer.
I'm back in Telluride on the mountain skiing. I feel strong and healthy.
Advanced medicine and technology.
And I am a survivor.
The warm embrace of the spirit in the power of prayer.
These are happy tears.
Please go to cancercenter.com/faith. Appointments available now. Cancer Treatment Centers of America, care that never quits.
Attention sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
The cost of rebuilding after that massive typhoon in the Philippines could be more than 50% higher than expected. Estimates for Typhoon Haiyan damage are reaching $3.1 billion. Haiyan was one of the strongest storms to make landfall anywhere, reducing everything in its path to rubble. Officials say the government underestimated the cost of rebuilding typhoon-resilient structures. The Philippines gets an average of 20 typhoons a year. Amazing, Mark.
Yeah, it really is.
Well, UNICEF reports that 4 million Filipino children still feel the trauma from that monster storm.
That's why CBN relief teams are still on the ground. Lucille Toulousan shows us how the ministry is using the Superbook cartoon to reach out to children.
It can be difficult to measure how much these children have been affected by Typhoon Haiyan. The monster storm took their loved ones, friends, homes, and schools. As a form of trauma counseling, the CBN Disaster Relief Team held Superbook screenings in the different villages hit hard by the typhoon.
For a community that doesn't have electric power for more than a month now, no television, no movies, the Superbook screening is a real treat to these children and also to their parents. And not only are they entertained, but they are fed the Word of God that brings them hope and values that they can apply in their lives.
We were walking home when my children saw Superbook on the screen. My children pleaded that we stop by and join the other children. And so now, we come here every night because my children said they want to see Papa Jesus. They are very happy, and I am thankful to Superbook because my children, who were traumatized by the typhoon, are not afraid anymore. Even I am hopeful again.
Each night, hundreds flocked to watch the animated Bible stories. Police officer Cheryl Morada is overwhelmed at the turnout, with 800 attending in one village. She is happy her station has supported the effort and escorted the CBN team.
We support Superbook because it is really unique from the rest. We get positive feedback from the parents that their children who became afraid of the rain have forgotten all about their fear because of Superbook.
I was crying because I can see the children are very happy. I really felt sorry for them. Because of the storm, they have to suffer so much. I want to thank you personally because I am so touched for how you are helping our children.
The theme song of Superbook truly fits their situation, especially the part in the Filipino language that says, "Help me begin again as I offer my life to you."
I can share what I learned from Superbook to my friends. We should be kind, generous, and obedient to our parents. And we can apply what the song says. Even if we were devastated by the storm, with God's help, we will be able to begin again and rebuild our lives.
It can take years or longer to erase the scars that Haiyan left in the minds of the children. But for every boy and girl attending the Superbook event, one good memory will remain embedded in their hearts. Lucille Toulousan, CBN News, Giwan Samar.
Up next, leading by example, how one man's decision to put God first influenced the success of a whole team.
Well, do ya? Yeah!
Then you're gonna love this. It's the new free Superbook Kids Bible app. You can play games, watch videos, find answers to your questions, and a whole lot more. The new Superbook Kids Bible app. Free downloads available on iTunes and Google Play now.
Jim is 38, mortgage, married, three great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. Jim can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $19 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll comparison shop the pick of insurance companies like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. Jim's wife, Deidre, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote. We shop, you save.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn-out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand-name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Welcome back. Football fans know the Carolina Panthers have been one of the surprises of the season. After the first few weeks, they looked to be dead in the water. Now they're division champs and made it to the playoffs.
One reason for the turnaround has been the leadership of star receiver Steve Smith. Recently, our Sean Brown sat down with the All-Pro wideout who talked about his own personal turnaround.
We're not exchanging cookie recipes. We're not, you know, we're not playing patty cake. It's, you know, one of my ex-teammates, Julius Pepper, 6'7". He's not coming to, you know, kind of pat me on the shoulder and say, hey, yeah, good catch. He's trying to knock my block off.
Carolina Panthers wide receiver Steve Smith has been described as one of the most aggressive receivers in the game. At 5'9", 185 pounds, he's easily one of the smallest, but he's also one of the most productive.
When you're playing football, you line up against guys that may be a little bit bigger, you have to take something to the field to be competitive. People call that a chip.
Yes, some people call it.
Some people call that a chip on your shoulder.
In this business, I make a lot of money, but at the same time, I work with my hands. And when you work with your hands and you're working a blue-collar job, you gotta bring your hard hat.
Yeah.
And so that's what I believe in. I believe in doing it with your whole heart. There's, as God said, there's gonna be one person that win the prize. So run the race to win the prize.
That approach seems to have paid off. For his first 8 seasons, Steve tore up the field with his strong hands and quick feet. Opposing teams would even assign 2 players to defend him. During the 2005 season, the 5-time Pro Bowler led the league in receptions, receiving yards, and touchdowns. But with the success he had on the field came a sense of pride that caused him to neglect the faith he had found years earlier.
I accepted Christ in the boiling room of Tampa Bay, 2003. I accepted Christ, but I didn't understand the responsibility, understand the full lifelong commitment, the true covenant between a believer, myself, and with Christ. And so just kind of was lukewarm, was straddling the fence, you know, kind of looked for it when I needed it, but when I didn't need it, just kind of shoved it to the side.
With pride in the driver's seat, that chip on Steve's shoulder led to physical altercations with opposing players and even teammates. And one morning during the 2010 season, he took a long, hard look at himself.
I really just did not recognize the man, the young man in the mirror. I didn't recognize him, I didn't see it, I didn't like what I saw. Vain, egotistical, self-centered. The world revolved around me. And it was the only important thing at that time was me. And that's not how real life works. That's not what it's about. That's not what a husband ought to think or ought to be. That's not what a father ought to be.
He says that's when he was faced with a question from God.
God just really broke me and asked me that question that I think everyone has in different ways, which was, you know, you've played this game long enough for yourself. When are you going to start playing for me? And so that was a question that was, it hit home.
At that moment, Steve decided it was time to get off the fence. So he rededicated his life to the Lord.
It really took me, statistically, that was pretty much the worst year I've had in my professional career outside of breaking my ankle. After going to Super Bowl, but spiritually and mentally and physically, it was probably the most best year I've had.
Steve had found peace within himself and on the field. He says he's made a lot of bad choices in his career, but his best decision was getting serious with Christ. And now, he's all about leading by example and sharing his story of God's unwavering love.
You can have your bank account at Morgan Stanley, Wells Fargo, Bank of America, every big business. But on that weekend, they aren't open. At midnight, when you're broken, that bank account is gonna help you. God has been in my life, whether I've known it or not, and been looking out for me the days that he knows, he's known. And he's been there in the muck and the mire. For me, he's redemptive. He's that father that even when your dad is, when he's striking out, that he'll hold you.
Up next, taking advantage of the recent polar vortex to raise awareness for a big cause.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Finally tonight, the polar vortex has finally eased its grip on the U.S. Many states are expecting warmer temperatures this weekend.
Looking forward to that.
Yes.
But some areas of the country are still seeing some icy conditions, which means most construction plans need to be put on hold unless you are building an ice house. For the month of January, Habitat for Humanity is building an ice house in Duluth, Minnesota. Although the structure has walls and a roof, it isn't your traditional house, and no family will be living there.
Something that, in theory, one of us could stay in overnight, but I don't know if any of us are going to brave that.
Habitat for Humanity will use the ice house to raise awareness and explain their mission.
Interesting.
Yeah.
I would not want to stay there.
I would not either.
For an hour. That would be too long for me. Unless you could build a little fire.
Yeah. And then it would all melt. That's all for this edition of NewsWatch.
Stay warm. Bye-bye.